Welcome, 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 welcome. This is your host, Rob Williams. I do not support bureaucracy, but they still call me the fine bureaucrat who knows pretty much everything.
Whoa! And I'm the co-host, Will Bobians.
Yes, I wanted to try something different here. Last week was nothing sort of insane, as we saw... Merck's boyhood dream come true, and beat that inferno in a matter of seconds. Well, not really seconds, but he was almost executed by the evil inferno, but turns out that he took the longer shortcut and managed to defeat him thanks to the interference of Duke, not to mention all the other crazy things that have been happening around here.
Yeah,
we will set light on then, as we kick off our first match of the evening.
It's a handicap match.
Interesting. Who the heck is that? She's having a knife and she has that weird black clothing. She's Merck! He's making his debut here. I mean, he's making his first appearance ever since he won that World Championship. No problem.
That's kind of surprising. What is the meaning of this match?
Oh my god! Merck almost got pinned. To see, I presume this woman is part of CEEV.
You would be correct. That is Bertina Alopa. One of her newest recruits.
Bertina Alopa. Interesting. What does she do?
She's the head of our PR department. She's making sure that CEEV remains a steady reputation. And right now, we have a problem that you keep referring to former Inferno faction as the Resistance. Though we are the true Resistance, we are not the status quo.
Well, I mean, you seem to have been taking over this RWL thingy for quite a while now. Merck is actually getting his ass by these two.
We have our reasons to go after Merck. We will not disclose them.
That's bizarre. Well, he did embarrass you last week when he managed to defeat your champion.
He's getting training. Merck's day will come.
But right now,
we'd like to put these two to make sure that Merck gets a proper beating up, so that he will lose his confidence.
Oh, so you aren't interested in executing any people?
No, and besides, we can't. We can only make the last match be about execution.
Stupid rules. Merck tapped out. Hold on, did it wasn't Inferno escorted out by Clarence and Ted Duke?
Oh yes, that was actually insane. And still, I'm sure we will get our hands back to those morons, however.
Everyone's ganging up on poor Merck. She's heard us posing, that is a sign of something great.
That doesn't count because it's not in the ring.
Well, for some reason they keep insisting to Merck to be on the ring side.
Ooh, it's a classic CEEV tradition. He can't ever even sit out of Merck.
Maybe they want him to get injured, he's stopping out again. Despite the fact he stopped it out, it doesn't count because they are on the ringside and apparently there is some sort of an earthquake going on.
It's one of those Indian earthquakes.
But we aren't in India, sorry.
But I will get back to my own.
Thank you for joining us, Lambert Bomber. I wonder if we get more disclosure on who this Pretina Lopa person is.
Oh no! Do they want Merc loose by count-out?
I wouldn't be surprised if they did. We need to cut this off. Max decided, do your worst.
I just noticed that she has a unique feel.
Pretty much every RWL wrestler has a unique feel. I mean, CEEV member on it, at least.
Pretina already got injured.
Well, that was a short debut. What will the next match in the United agenda be?
It's a hardcore one-on-one match.
Okay. We haven't seen her for a while.
Who is she planning to take on?
Forter. You would think Forter would go after actual people, but I think some attended sage. Oh yes, thank you everyone for supporting for my return.
No! Listen here, Forten! You have been too mean to me! Don't you realize that my era with Ditkus is over? I want to be a free woman again!
Oh, who cares, Bukharin? Come here so I can teach you a lesson. Well, this is a surprise indeed. I mean, didn't Forten already get his ass kicked hard enough at the last week's battle?
I absolutely have no clue.
Well, he tried to defeat. He was kidnapped by a mysterious man for a few weeks. That referred to himself as... I mean, it was some sort of a man in a hat that used a hammer to peel something. That was so horrible, Forten doesn't even remember it. Whoa! Almost a pinfall there.
Tell me about it. Yes, Forten is trying his best now. But I have no clue why Pukakin and these two are fighting. Apparently Forten still seems to associate Pukakin with Ditkus, despite the fact Pukakin is ready to move on.
Well, I mean, where could the heck could Pukakin move on?
Pinfall attempt, but it was too late because the table was on the way.
That's idiotic. But Lisa Marie Ann's lies back, that's very nice. Water with a very nice Superman punch.
It's a table trouble. Pukakin stepping out.
Water wins. Not too bad, if I say so myself.
Well, Forten already beat something interesting here, but let us move into our but there is something happening in the backstage.
Oh, that was a match, I tell ya. So, how do we get Inferno back to normal?
I have absolutely no clue. But from what I hear from the Duke, there might be somebody who might know.
Well, who is it?
It's me. The reason why I can make porridge that can cancel brainwashing.
What?
Yes, that is right. I accidentally found out the recipe back in the 2018. So I decided to bring it back. The long story short is, me and Gigolo heard that the Tomba brothers were talking about sleeping some sort of a brainwashing capsule behind Inferno's back. So I decided to make my own capsule out of that porridge which can stop brainwashing. So I gave it to Gigolo and forced him to run in during that match. Gigolo wasn't able to slam it on Inferno's back though, so his brainwashing did take place during that unfortunate spot.
Oh my god, that actually makes perfect sense. And CEEV wanted to execute you because they actually found out about your porridge.
Correct, but they didn't take into account that I had already told the Duke about it when I was drunk.
Interesting. So this explains a lot of things.
Indeed. We better get into making that porridge, Merc. How long does it take?
It actually, I used the last remaining resources of it into that porridge capsule. It might take an entire week to make because it's such hard to make porridge. It involves burying it into the ground for a few days and then boiling it again and then actually mailing it to Timbuktu and back so that it could truly harvest into it. It's one of the hardest porridges to make in the world.
Well, that's just prime. How the hell are we supposed to keep Inferno away from CEEV until the porridge is finished?
Well, do not worry. I can find my ways to keep my friend away.
Whoa! So Merc is now part of the resistance all along.
That's amazing.
Let us hope that Merc is able to make that porridge without getting caught. But we have our next match to get into.
Yes.
It's a one-on-one match, of course. Euby!
We haven't seen her for a while, which is very nice. It's about time we got to see her on action again.
I wonder who she's facing. Old PH, of course.
That guy just wants to go in every show, no, regardless of the situation.
Yes, I think Old PH, last week Old PH faced off against... I think he faced off against Dai. I can't really remember.
Yeah, Old PH hasn't been really doing anything after Omni beat him up.
Omni and Vex joined forces to beat him and Jezebel Jackson up. Yes, Old PH must be the most frequently appeared RWL star to this day.
Yes, at least in this new rebuild.
Oh my god! Old PH beating a Euby up. Let us hope that Euby scores a victory here.
Well, I for one am tired of these meaningless matches. I still have no idea what will happen at anniversary. Asinine anniversary.
Well, their time will tell. I'm pretty sure Merc will get... fighting with those CEEV members.
Euby, he was the poor girl was lost at acting championship as after Cassie betrayed him.
Yeah, yes, but later Daron the Mystic and the Duke took those acting championship to their own hands. I hope this doesn't build up to a reveal that Killed Hakobur is actually Euby's mother as well.
Well, they aren't even the same part of the... Well, at least they have the skin color difference.
Yeah. I really hate...
What did you hate?
I really hate over, like, people who just think they are so smart, you know? They know everything about everything. And I think Old PH comes across that way, especially when he talks about younger people. Oh my god! No. Euby has no friend in the world except for Garon the Mystic, but he's not in this match for some reason.
He's probably hiding.
Yeah, very likely. But why would he be holding the tag team championships if he's hiding?
Oh! Something exploded.
It was the beer battle that killed Hakobur too. I don't know why I drew attention to that.
Old PH continuing those his brutal ways.
Well... All patches hit Euby with a flying nothing, so that's good.
Could this be it? No, it's a double pin.
No. Old PH almost hit a Superman punch. Oh my god. One. Two.
You, old PH failed. Old PH is just showing that he's the god of the old phase.
Yes. This guy has a long history of watching Tennessee wrestling. It's no wonder that this guy shows no mercy.
Yeah, he's pretty iconic, all things considered. Especially when you think about his track record in the, match department.
Yes, he's never held major titles. If we don't count RWL Championship back when he was KFB number one, but that was never an official.
Pro break!
Old PH. Euby shows her capabilities against old PH. I don't think these two have faced off yet.
Yeah, it's a new matchup.
Yes, one of those promise we promised that this year, new characters, new matchups. It didn't go so well. We
never did that, did we?
Oh, I swear we did something like that in 2018. Whatever. Tilda Hakobo is trying to do something wacky there with her blank thingy. Maybe we will see some returning faces at the upcoming Nostalgia Pandering Battle Royale. Winner gets a contract and gets to return full time.
Oh, yes, you talked about that a few times already.
This match is going nowhere fast.
It is, especially because there is no rivalry behind it all. It's not building up to anything.
Why are we shooting so much?
I have no clue.
But the audience loves it, so we have no reason to use the match decider to cut the curb. One. Two. It's not over yet. Euby has gotten a lot stronger. Look, she managed to avoid old PH's attack just by wall.
But old PH is a very strong...
Oh no, here we go again to the outside of the ring. Oh, I wish somebody would come here and talk with us, so that we could have something else to focus on.
Yes, did you ask for somebody to talk to you?
Oh, hello, Rat. It's been a while. How was the power struggle at Creativity?
Well, let's just say that I have officially won it. Guy is too busy going after that Arabian Night guy. So why not? Why shouldn't I be doing anything else but to continue running Creativity just the way I want it?
Well, that is interesting, right? What about those GMAC guys?
Don't remind me about them. They think they are smart, but they just fap. Hold on, let me interfere for fun.
Oh, well, that's unexpected. That's the first time when somebody who comes to commentate with us interferes in the middle of the match. I wonder what this means.
He's attacking... Rat is attacking Euby.
But I thought Euby left Creativity a long ago.
Looks like Rod still wants revenge.
They are going into the backstage again.
Rod's purpose here is completely empty.
He's just pointing wackily at things.
Euby fell. Old PH is posing.
He's walking in a place, the devil.
It's kind of sad when everyone's ganging up on Euby. She's definitely not having a fun time.
She's still got that bad luck. Even though she won that tag team match at Travis Cicada Medved, or was it someone else?
I don't remember.
Now she's at King Lisa Marie Enstor. Don't get confused.
Everyone's... Oh! What accidentally hit Kilda Cooper and old PH?
That mistake can happen sometimes. Euby is running back into the ring. pinfall at them, but it's a rope break. Hold the edge smack in her head. Like, it's like a little grapefruit. Grapefruit, that thing.
Yeah, a grapefruit.
Grapefruit. What did you just say?
Yeah, you said grapefruit.
So I decided to say grapefruit with you. What the hell? Grapefruit or grapefruit? As in, fruit is like, sounds like a fart of some kind.
I think grapefruit is funnier. Grapefruit sounds like... Maybe it's...
I don't like this conversation. I wish this match ended so that we could have actual things to talk about. We shit talk a lot here.
Well, some people say they enjoy our shit talking.
Do you have 3 peer review sources to prove that, right?
No.
Well, I thought so. Well, at least somebody's saying go Euby with a very small text. Why is there so much blankness? Did they try to draw Euby in it, but their art style was so terrible that they decided to just blank cover it up?
We don't see any creative signs anymore. We just see names and people swearing and GDIC. And somebody wants Deukwai to appear in this match. Yet she's in church.
In church?
Yes, I have pronunciation problems. I was the world's worst at spelling back in the day.
Yes, I totally know what those are. Somebody in the audience also used to be a wrestler. That's interesting. Why couldn't they come interfere in this and make this a little bit more interesting?
Well, I hope I better go and talk. Maybe they are gaslighting. They probably were never a wrestler.
I wish I saw what that guy looked like.
Here comes Gilbert Cooper to help.
But oh, it's going crazy here. We might go into a time limit draw as expected. Why do they always go into a time limit draw? The most boring matches always go to a time limit draw with no meaning.
Maybe this has some inner meaning, and maybe this is just old Pietro trying to prove that he's not an old car.
He already tried to prove that he's not an old car for like 50 million times. And old PH is flipping off the ground, because that's so mature.
Ooh. Oh, you be attempting something, but it's a rope break. You be your brainless gold.
Oh. Rope break. This, oh my god, you be truly some Ariens out of the ring. And now old PH truly, you be out of the ring.
Euby is definitely not having fun. 1 minute remaining.
Here comes Rock. Prototype!
Well, I hope he at least is here to beat up Euby. I mean, not beat up Euby.
What the hell does Prototype want? Silent Stranger is nowhere to be found.
Maybe he wants to take on... Oh no, he's also here to beat up Euby.
No. Poor Euby, why does everyone in the audience want to beat him up?
No, if I think about it, maybe beating up Euby is fun. Maybe I will go there too.
Don't! You remember what happened last time when you tried to beat up a wrestler in the match? We got, like, hit with 30 lawsuits.
Sorry about that. Nobody won this contest.
Euby. You better get your ass back towards creativity of where you belong. I will challenge you at anniversary and Anderson on anniversary. Fine, bring it on, you bitch. You don't call me a bitch. Fine, let us see who's the king of RWL there.
Oh my god. The show that did serve a purpose. Rat and Euby are going to face off at Asinine Anniversary!
This is going to be amazing.
Yes.
The Massapi, Rat, why do you want to challenge Euby to a match when she hasn't been in creativity for like 8 months now?
Well, the answer is simple. When your own people are rebelling against you, you know they are working with outside sources. I've let enough people leave creativity and spread nasty rumors about it. I know Euby hasn't had a good luck at all after leaving creativity. Partner after partner has betrayed her. So I believe that Yubi's future is with Creativity. Although she's not good at anything, I know that only we can provide her the comfort she needs.
I know Euby will not probably face that much of a challenge, because all the Creativity members, from what I have heard, have gone soft, thanks to Guy and Mari Cervantes.
Well, I will change that. Well, if I manage to beat Euby, I will make sure that she gets the worst treatment possible. Mark my words.
Oh, that's worrying. But thank you, Rat, and back to the studio.
Wow. Why is Rat want Euby to return to the creativity so bad?
He's probably getting very desperate.
Anyways, it's time for our next match of the evening.
It's a one-on-one match,
as expected. Drakes! Well, I am surprised to see him active.
It seems like there is no clear definition of what does he want to do.
His partner, anybody lost to Rat last week or something like that. Thank Threshold.
Well, this is an interesting continuation of this. Former hardcore champion and all.
Well, let me tell you something. Thank Threshold, you should know better than to hang out with losers like Rat.
Don't trust me! I do what I want, you goddamn rapist!
Well, that's a big bite to swallow.
Looks like Tank Threshold is taking her aggression out on the person that she managed to beat last 2 weeks ago with GMAC teaming up together with Guy and Mari Cervantes to put a stop to stupidity of Rat and the others, as well as Rosa and Elkai, who are currently both injured.
What is that god-awful noise? Is somebody making laundry here?
No, I think that's actually I think that is actually the training facility. We are in Dulce Nuggets, Texas, where there is a training facility nearby.
Oh, but we're running on it. I hope it's somebody important. Either way, it's making a lot of noise. I can't really hear the sounds of the match.
What could they be saying?
Drake draws Mari Cervantes to the outside. Frank Threshold. I'm getting my names wrong again. It's been a while.
Frank Threshold with a submission attempt, but it fails.
Oh, smacking her. Rat comes to help Drakes. It's been a while. They continue brawling on the outside. Tank Threshold is desperately trying to get into the... Is she injured?
No, I think she's not.
Alright. Slamming Drakes to the back of the mat.
No! She's gone again. This match will now go on even longer.
Here she comes. Oh! She does a very nice lift. To Drakes.
Pinfall. One.
Pinfall reversal. One. Well, that was odd. And now everyone's getting thrown out.
Yes, Rod came in and started acting weird.
Frank Threshold is stepping out. Drake wins.
Well, that was fast.
That should put Frank Threshold on a... make Frank Threshold become a victim of some kind.
She's actually doing pretty poorly, if I say so myself.
Yes, losing her hardcore championship and now doing job to tricks.
What's next, Jeff?
Who's Jeff? I am not Jeff, I am Rob.
Nothing. Oh, it's a competitive championship defense.
Bank Threshold again. Who granted her a double duty?
I have no idea. But here comes Clarence Mason. He's now accompanied. Looks like Axe found a new guy to bet on.
It begins with not much words said. And just like in the last match, they instantly insist on going on outside. Oh my god. Does Bank Threshold have energy to take on, Clarence Mason?
I absolutely have zero clue.
Rot with our dropkick.
Well, I personally can't believe Frank Threshold has been double booked. We rarely have double duties these days.
Yes, they were common back in the old days. But RWL has such a big roster. How? When was the last time we saw Gigolo on action, besides that interference he did?
Well, Clarence does like to defend his championship a lot. Axe is now giving him a beating in the outside.
Oh my god, Rod also went through those stairs. Why is Clarence attacking Axe?
He was probably dizzy. Pank Threshold attacking. Clarence strikes back, however.
Yes. This guy has been he has been the competitive champion for a pretty long time. Originally created by Das Weber, owned by Casper Passable for like a week. I think he owned it for a week until he lost it, to Clarence Mason. And so far, this has been no. Besides the first defense, there has been no competitive clauses on these matches.
It's kind of hard.
Rod tells him that it should, I mean... I do remember the time when, Simon's little one did that rolls in one night. I've mentioned that for like a billion times.
Oh yes, and there was that one time when,
that somebody was on the, that somebody got a title instantly. Newt! It was Newt! Newt lost one match and lost his tag team partner, and then he decided to take part in that champ match for the one title shot or something like that. Yes, I remember it. Clarence Mason and Frank Threshold fighting. Clarence Mason almost drops in. Oh my goodness, that almost hit him. Oh, smacking him to the face.
Punk Threshold, despite losing to Drake, she's still trying her best.
Well, I don't think that's her best, that's her third best or something. Oh, almost a pinfall. Clarence Mason had a lost few weeks ago against Gunnhallen, but it didn't count because it was a countout. And championships do not change by a countout or a disqualification, at least here. What was that? Nothing. Ooh, Clarence Mason with a... What was that? Something was on fire. Clarence Mason with an elbow off the top rope. Oh my god. No. Bank Threshold still manages to put up a good fight. Pinfall. But it failed. I seem think Bank Threshold is desperate for another defense of the Hardcore Championship. Yes, or at least some sort of relevancy after losing it to Sin Carlos of all people.
Yes.
Here comes Axe. Boy, it would have been awkward if Clarence had accidentally hit Axe at the time. Could you imagine if Axe betrayed him? What the hell would he do?
Well, they would have one less person. I don't think Axe has taken part in the Resistance that much.
Yes. Resistance is easily one of the weirder factions in RWL history because, unlike most other factions, the members seem to come from other factions and they really do not have some sort of, they have fleeting loyalty to the faction.
Yes, compared to other factions in the history of RWL, like Hi-Fish, Upper Avenue, Creative Dictatorance, GMAC, Crap Hole. Well, Crap Hole was kind of a fleeting back. People were leaving it every minute.
Yes, but even CEEV has more faithful people, of course. It seems that Silent Stranger has now officially left the faction. Oh! Clarence attacks Lisa Marie Enslaw. Leave her out of the... Well, looks like she also tapped out from that. Clarence Mason is the winner.
Congratulations to him.
I love that song. Such a shame that it gives me bitter memories of when Inferno wasn't brainwashed.
How did Clarence Mason have time to take part in a match if Inferno is out of the reach of those, to keep Inferno out of reach of CEEV members?
I have no clue, but it's time for our main event. This one's going to be a big one.
It's a steel cage match.
This should be interesting. Who the heck is that?
It's the guy fought and talked about.
What is he doing here? What the heck is up with this team music? Why is he stuck on that? He's dragging on there like some sort of a... What is with that cane of his? Who is he facing? Gigolo! Of course!
Merc's friend!
He's not going to have a lot of fun here.
Why is Gigolo climbing Merc? It seems like this mysterious figure wants to take and teach Gigolo a lesson.
He's also dragging himself there. Did he? His brain just died.
Finally, you have seen who I really am. I am the Baron of Krieg. This will be my first execution match. Oh.
You shut up! I will teach you a listener!
Gigolo apparently began... Oh my god, she murdered Lisa Marie Enslaw in a matter of minutes!
This guy is strong! Gigolo's already tapping out!
Oh my god! What the hell just happened there?
Well, Gigolo's dead man now!
Gigolo, you have left all long enough, but I will spare your life. If you tell Merc to stop being a midwit moron and reject those plans for that porridge of his.
Oh, I will never do that. Why should I do that? He has the freedom to do what he wants.
No, freedom. is a concept almost by the most wicked of thieves like midwits like you.
What the hell is a midwit? I met some midwits back in the Hong Kong day.
You get what you fucking deserve!
Oh my god! Giggle all just exploded in blood! No man, he's... Don't throw up. Stay strong, Will.
None of you ever proved that a good had just happened.
He's gone.
This is my friend!
Oh, see what happens when you screw with CEEV. I'm really sorry that we had to unleash him on them so early.
What? Who was that man, Fish? Tell me!
Would you calm down, Rob? We all know this is just entertainment. Baron of Krieg set up a warning for all of those morons at the so-called resistance. Stop. Just surrender to our power. Let us change the world for the better.
You have now killed two people in the ring. How the hell are you making things better?
What the hell would have those two even contributed to RWL or the future of this world? We are trying to improve society, you know. Now, if you don't mind, we will leave. I hope this is enough for team resistance of all things good to give Inferno back to us, so that he could finish the job.
I am so mad!
Come on, Rob. What the hell else could they have done?
This mysterious hat character. It's like... it's no longer about a resistance versus CEEV. It's about the entire RWL versus CEEV. I am Rob Williams.
And I am Will Bobbians.
Good night.